when you deliberately conjure an image for the purpose of creating, we want you to understand that so often people think, well, I'm going to sit and do my creating now. And we want you to understand that all that visualization is practicing the vibration of letting what you've already asked for in. That this is just vibrational practice. All that visualizing is not making something happen. It's letting something that's already happened in. That's such an important distinction. You're not creating with your affirmations. You're not creating with your visualizations. You are practicing a vibration that lets it in. So the more visualizing you do, the more you set a tone that lets more in. So now we want to go back to the very first thing that you asked, because it's so important. This is the way we heard it. If I have 2 or 3 or 5 or 10, but let's say 2 things that I really want, do I split my energy by focusing upon 2 things rather than giving my undivided attention to 1 thing that I want? And we want to say to you, 2 things that you sort of kind of believe are much more powerful for you to focus upon than 1 thing that you doubt. In other words, so you want to use the things that you believe most as your reason to focus, because when you take a desire for something that you believe you can accomplish and you give your undivided attention to that thing in which you have belief, now you've practiced the vibration of belief, and now all the things that you want in that practice of belief must be allowed, even if you've been practicing this idea of belief on a different subject than the other things. Does that make sense? In other words, there's resisting and there's allowing, and it doesn't matter what you're using as your excuse to allow. Right. That's why we always say, start with the easy things. Start with the things that you believe. Because when you focus upon the things that you believe, you close the gap. And when you close the gap, you let in all the stuff you want.